In this video, we are going to discuss about a sequential circuit known as counter. So counter is a digital sequential circuit. What is the which is purpose of counter? Counter is used to counting the clock pulse used in a circuit, and it is a created using a group of flip-flop with a clock signal applied to it. With a group of flip-flop means we have already studied register, which is also a collection of group of flip-flop. You have saw the diagram of a register, which is a group of flip-flop. Similar, we can create a counter by using group of flip-flop. And clock signal is very essential part is counter, which is used to count the number of clock signal applied on a circuit. Now before we go to the designing of a counter, we have to know some points of a counter. So as the counter counts, it can count from any value starting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to any number. It can count like this. Again, it can count in the reverse order, means it can count 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this in reverse order. Again, not only that, it can count starting value from suppose 2, 4, 6, like this way, or 2, 3, 4, 5, like this way. So the starting value and the ending value of a counter depends upon the designing of a counter. It can start from any value and it can end to any value. Okay, so a counter has count in two ways. One, it counts from 0, 1, 2 in ascending order. This is known as up counter. And one, it's count in reverse order. When it counts in reverse order means 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this way. This is known as down counter. So down counter counts in reverse order and up counter counts in ascending order. This is our first point. So counter counts in two ways. Remember. Next, our next point is state of counter. So the state of counter is the present count of a counter that a counter can count. What does it mean? That is mean present count means the number of values a counter can count. That is obviously its present counter. A counter can count from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. A counter can count from 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A counter can count from 10, 9, 8, 7 in reverse order, anything. So that is the present count. And state of counter, how many numbers it can count. Let us see. If there are two counter, okay, two counter means what it's possible value. The first value is 0, second value is 0, first counter value, okay, this is 0. Again, first is 0, second is 1, value of this two counter, second value. Again, we get it's 1, it's 0, third value. Again, we get both are 1, fourth value. So, if there are two flip-flop, okay, then we get this fourth state. And you already see that the binary equivalent of this state is 0, 0 means 0, 0, 1 means 1, 1, 0 means 2, 1, 1 means 3. So the state of counter having two flip-flop is fourth state. How we get 4? That means 2 to the power 2 equals to 4. Okay, that is the state of this counter. Similarly, if we have a counter having three flip-flop, then the number of state is 2 to the power 3. 2 to the power 3 means 8. So if we start from 0, so we get it's counting up to 7. So 0 to 7 means 8. So 8 state means it can count 8 digit and starting from 0. So the truth table of 3 bits flip flop is this 000001. You have already studied this. This is for 3 bits value truth table. So the binary equivalent of this value is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 7. So if there are 3 flip flop, we get counting from 0 to 7 and it is 8 state. Okay. Now, so similarly, if there are 4 flip flop, its state of counter, what will be 2 to the power 4? 2 to the power 4 means 16. 16, we get 16 state if there are 4 flip flop. And for this 16 state, the counting value will be starting, if we start from 0, it counts from 0 to 15. So 0 to 15 is also 16 state. So in our overall, we can say that if there are n flip flop in a counter, then we get state of counter is 2 to the power n. Okay, so if there are n flip flop, then the possible state is 2 to the power state 2 to the power sorry 2 to the power n, and this is a present count, that means the number of digits it can count. So 2 to the power n is the number of digit it can count. So if there are 4 flip flop, sorry 2 flip flop, it counts 4, so its present count is 4. If there are 3 flip flop, it counts 8 state, so its present count is 8. If there are 4 flip flop, it has 16 state, so present count is 16, and so on. Now we are going to study maximum count. What is maximum count? Suppose we have already studied that if there are 2 flip flop, there are 4 state. 4 state means it can count 4 digit. 4 digit. 4 digit means it can count 0, 1, 2, 3. If we start from 0, it counts 0, 1, 2, 3. So it is 4 digit. Here the maximum value is 3. This is the maximum count of a counter having 2 flip-flop. Okay. Suppose a counter have 3 flip-flop. So its possible state, we have seen before, 2 to the power 3. That means 8 possible state. 8 possible state means it can count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And here maximum count is 7. Okay. Similarly, if there are 4 flip-flop, possible state will be 2 to the power 4 equals to 16. Okay, so it can count 0 to 15. Okay, so maximum count will be 15. Now I think all of you have noticed that the number of possible state is 1 times maximum than the number of maximum counts. Or in other words, you can say that maximum count is one number less than its possible count. If there are possible max per state is 4, maximum count is 3. If there are possible state is 8, maximum count is 7. If there are possible state is 16, maximum count will be 15. So always maximum count will be 1 times less than its possible state. We can see that if there are n flip flop, possible state would be 2 to the power n minus 1. Okay. Now our next important part is mod number. What is mod number? Mod number is the number of possible state of a counter. We have already learned what is possible state. Possible state is if there are the number of flip flop will get the power of 2 in order to get the possible state. So if there are 2 flip flop, possible state will be 4. So a counter having 2 flip flop having 4 possible state, we can also call that mod 4 counter. Again, if a count mod 10 counter means a counter having 10 possible state, 10 possible state means it can count 0 to 9. Suppose a counter mod 8 counter. Mod 8 counter means it can count 8 possible states. So if we start from 0, we get 0 to 5. Suppose another example, a counter having mod 5. So it is 5 possible state. So if it start from 0, we get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the possible state. So mod 5 means a counter having 5 possible state. Okay, so this will be the possible state, 0 to 4. This is the mod number. Okay, now there are two types of counter. One here, according to its counting process, we have seen that two counters, one is up counter and one is down counter, and this variation is done according to its counting process. Two types of counter, one is asynchronous counter, another is synchronous counter. So asynchronous and synchronous, so we have all learned before that synchronous means all the flip-flops in a counter works on a single same clock pulse. That is, synchronous counter, at first we see synchronous counter, this is a counter having two flip-flop, this is a JK counter, a JK flip-flop, and you see that clock signal is applied to each counter, same clock pulse is applied to each counter. Okay, this is the synchronous counter. So in synchronous counter, all the clock pulse for each flip-flop goes from a same clock pulse. This is one point. Another point is, the input of first flip-flop gives outside, and the input of other flip-flop goes from the output of previous flip-flop. Notice it very carefully. Two things for synchronous counter. One is, same clock pulse will go for each flip-flop, same clock pulse. So if it's 0, it also 0, it also 0. If it is 1, it also 1, it also 1 gets activated. Okay, this is the first point. And the second point is, you see that the first input gives from outside, and the second input for every flip-flop will get from the output of its previous flip-flop. Okay, this is for synchronous. And for asynchronous, you say that, so obviously asynchronous, same clock pulse will not apply for each flip-flop. So what is, do see, for the first flip-flop we'll get one clock pulse, and the for second clock it will get clocked value from the output of the previous flip-flop. Mind it, it gets its clock in asynchronous flip-flop, gets its clock value from the output of previous flip-flop, but in synchronous it clock goes same clock pulse. This is first difference. Second is, you see there, in synchronous the next flip-flop gets its input from previous output, but in asynchronous for every flip-flop it gives separate input value. Okay, so this is asynchronous and this is synchronous flip-flop. And as all the flip-flop works for the same clock value, that means activated or deactivated for the same clock value, it is also known as parallel counter. And here, as the same clock value is not given to each flip-flop, when the first flip-flop gets one, only for then second flip-flop will get activated. That means when clock is one, it will get activated. So when it will get activated, When its output is 1, then that output value goes to its clock and it gets activated. When its value is 0, this value is not activated. So one time it's activated and one time it is not activated. That's why it's known as also ripple counter. Ripple means one time it's 0, another time it's 1, one time is 0 in a toggle position. These are the two types of counter according to their designing, okay, for their clock signal. Now we see the difference of asynchronous and synchronous. Very important for us. First of all, in synchronous, there is no connection between first flip-flop output and the clock. Obviously, in synchronous, output of first flip-flop is not connected with the clock pulse, okay? So there is no connection between the output of first flip-flop and the clock pulse. This output and this clock pulse have no connection for synchronous counter. But for asynchronous counter, flip-flops are connected in such a way that the output of first flip-flop derives out the clock of next. So its output gives the clock for the next flip-flop. So this is the first difference. Second difference is flip-flops are clocked simultaneously. For every flip-flop, clocks will give the activated or deactivated for the same clock pulse. But here, obviously, clocks are not simultaneously. When it is 1, it is 0, it is 1, it is 0, like this way. In synchronous, circuit becomes complicated when the state increases. That is, when the 2 flip-flop, we get 4 state. When the 3 flip-flop, we get 8 state. When the 4 flip-flop, we get 16 state. Like this way, when the number of flip-flop increase, in order to get the number of many number of digits, many number of states, we have to increase the number of flip-flop. And for synchronous circuit, when the number of flip-flop increases, its design will becomes very complicated. You will see later how it becomes complicated. But for synchronous circuit, the circuit is simple for more number of state. Now, obviously, as all the clocks are connected for each flip-flop activated deactivated at the same clock pulse, here propagation delay is very low than the synchronous flip-flop. Because synchronous flip-flop, as the clocks are not connected simultaneously, its propagation delay is high. Speed of flip-flop is high and speed of this is low. There is another main point. Large number of logic gates are required to design. Okay. You will get how large number of logic gates are designed when you are going to design flip-flop, then you can understand this. And there are small number of means this, that in synchronous circuit we get more logic gates than to design asynchronous circuits. So as number of logic gates requirement is high, so its cost also high and it is low cost comparatively. So these are the difference of synchronous and asynchronous counter.